स्वामी जी, इन भगवद गीता कृष्णा आस्क्स अर्जुना टू फाइट। हाउ डज दैट मैच विथ योर टीचिंग ऑन अहिंसा? हाउ डू वी डिसाइड वेन टू फाइट एंड वेन टू एक्सरसाइज अहिंसा?
The same Bhagavad Gita, Arjuna is asked to be established in enlightenment at least in few hundred slokas. Understand? Krishna may be telling Arjuna to fight in one or two slokas, but he is using hundreds of slokas to establish Arjuna in enlightenment. See, if you are established in enlightenment, you will only defend, you will not hurt anybody one inch more. All I am saying is, for the sake of truth, satya and dharma, how much you need to defend yourself, do that much, not more than that. Not more than that. Do not hurt anybody. Do not be violent on anybody. Don't have any secret plans to take revenge on anybody. As long as you do things to protect yourself, defending, that's perfect. In Arjuna's case, it's like a life and death situation. Either he has to kill or he will be killed. But in our case, I don't see that. Even the people cherish so much of enmity against me, I don't feel that we need to take revenge on anybody and be violent on anybody. And one more thing, if Arjuna loses his body, he loses his life. In my case, I am going to be eternal. I have already realized. So no need for any violence and revenge. I know for sure, nothing can be lost. So being established in compassion, being established in the enlightenment, non-violence is the best strategy planning for the whole life. Even today, the Devi who writes in the rice, whatever questions you have, she writes automatically and answers all your questions. I saw, it's true, it's not lie, it's not false that the guys who are holding the Devi are writing. No, it's such a heavy deity. You can't hold that huge piece and write so easily as you want, so perfectly, without spelling mistake, and such a clear way. It is just the true energy of Devi writing through the deity. Even today, to her I prayed, let the Devi bless all of us with the highest intelligence of Nityananda and deep compassion to handle this whole situation. The priest asked me, Swamiji, you want any request or question for Devi? I said only this much. Let her give us all a deep compassion and ahimsa to handle this whole thing and not to hurt anybody in any way. And live with that deep ahimsa and compassion. I tell you one thing, even in a practical way, understand, I am the head of such a big organization, inspiring millions of people. Because of my compassion and non-violent attitude, people have not been inspired to do violent things. It is such a wonderful positive trend we are setting for the future. And I wanted to set a right trend for the future, because we have a great future. And not only that, we have recovered already. You see, we don't have the load of taking revenge on others. See, if you have the load and secret plans of taking revenge on others, it takes years of our time. Only after a few years, when we finish taking revenge on everybody, we will feel that we have achieved our goal. But that's waste of time, useless. Now already we feel we are out of this whole thing, and let us start progressing. Let us start creating. See, let us show our greatness by creating good things, not by taking revenge on people. To take revenge on people, to do something negative, you don't need an incarnation. Ordinary few rowdies are enough. Nothing more is needed. Few thugs are enough. Nothing more is needed. But to be creative, to contribute to the society, more and more enlightened beings, you need an incarnation. So let us do our life's purpose. Let us do our life's purpose. That is what, even when they put me in prison, I did not have any problem sleeping peacefully, comfortably, just because of my deep compassion and no revenge, no vengeance. Understand, in prison enlightenment is not a luxury, it's a basic utility. You can't rest. You see, it's not like a pride, I am enlightened, I am enlightened. No, it is just a basic utility. You have to be enlightened to be in peaceful, to be restful, to be relaxed, to be blissful. And it's a basic utility. I tell you, being established in this compassion and ahimsa really, really, really is useful, even in the practical way for the life. You can just recover from any crisis. See, life will be filled usually with many crises. It's a way of life, nothing else. So if you have compassion and ahimsa, you will not have the load of taking revenge on people, unnecessary extra work, which takes away your energy and attention. Not only as a morality, but as a science of life, as an art of life, as a science of life, I tell you, non-violence and ahimsa and compassion is one of the best strategy for life.